prove if a diagonal of a rhombus bisects a pair of opposite angles, then the parallelogram is a rhombus. So we're given that this diagonal drawn, AC, bisects the pair of opposite angles. And then we're going to end up proving that ABCD is a rhombus. So let's put our first given. Angle BCA congruent to angle DCA, and angle BAC congruent to angle DAC. And our strategy here is going to be to prove the two triangles are congruent, and then eventually we can prove that we have a rhombus. Now our next reason is reflexive property of congruence, so we know it has to be segment AC congruent to segment AC. Now actually, we have enough to prove that the triangles are congruent now because we have angle-side-angle situation. We have BCA and DCA, and we have BAC and DAC, and then we have segment AC. If you're having a hard time seeing it, I suggest you draw the parallelogram on your own paper and mark the congruent angles and sides, and you'll see very easily why you have an angle-side-angle. So we can say these two triangles are congruent, and the reason why is angle-side-angle triangle congruence theorem. And next we can say the sides BC and DC are congruent, and AB and AD are congruent because of corresponding parts of congruent triangles congruent. And the way the triangle congruence works, it's kind of like this is a reflection situation here, because the way the corresponding angles worked out, the angles on this side are congruent, and the angles on this side are congruent, so you're just reflecting over. So B maps to D in a reflection. So now we can say ABCD is a parallelogram. That was the second given statement. And the next reason is property of parallelograms. And what we're going to do here is we're going to say the segment DC is congruent to segment BA. Opposite sides of a parallelogram are congruent. Okay. So now we only have one more statement and one more reason. The statement is that all four sides are congruent. And basically all you do here is you have the statement 4 and then you have the statement 6. So it's like the statement 6 puts a congruent symbol between the DC and the AB. So then you just have all four sides congruent now. And that's using the transitive property of congruence. And then finally, you can conclude that ABCD is a rhombus by the definition of a rhombus because we have four congruent sides on our parallelogram. Okay, so that's the completed proof that shows if a diagonal of a parallelogram bisects a pair of opposite angles, then the parallelogram is a rhombus.